Hey everyone, thanks for showing up. Had a couple requests to do a start to finish video, and so here we are in a three-part series, roughly 30 minutes each. I'm using an old school Dremel here. It's a Dremel 370. From the late 70s, early 80s. Still seems to work well, besides the fact that it's, I think there's a bearing going out. Always start with the eyes on a piece. It seems to provide a proper anchor point for the rest of the face. Using a ball saber bit here. It's a green one. Actually, this one's actually 8 years old, believe it or not, and it still does a pretty good job. There's a few teeth that are knocked off. I think I hit some metal at one point when I was carving in the past. This piece of wood is a pine knot. I have shit tons of that stuff on my property, and never a dull moment, you know, when it comes to carving. Thing I like about the pine knots is the quality of the wood. It's not like wood, it's more like plastic when you're carving it. Sometimes it's heavily resonated, and it's like the toughest part of the tree, it seems like, because it's the last part to go as it's decomposing on the ground. Yeah, this part's actually the boring part because it's not really much going on. You're just like, you know, carving out the eye sockets or whatever. And then, you know, it's not really coming into view yet, so. Yeah, I'll shut up for a bit here so you guys can check out the video. You don't have to listen to my babbling voice, so anyway. I'll be back in a bit, so anyway. Okay, back again. We're at a point here where we're drawing in the eyes, and for reference purpose. Just switching bits here. I'm going to a smaller bit, you know, for more details and some around the eyes here. Basically try to get the definition going on. This particular piece, I don't have any reference pictures or photos I'm going from. It's just extemporaneous in nature. And sometimes it's fun to do that because you never know what the end result's gonna be. It's more or less up to the wood to tell you what's gonna happen. Yeah, I cranked up the RPMs max right now, and then you could definitely hear some kind of bearing issue with the Dremel. You know, I looked online, I couldn't find any replacement. Maybe I gotta look a little harder, who knows. But this Dremel is so old, I don't know, it was given to me like a couple years ago, but I decided to try it anyway. And it's still runs, but just got some minor issues. It's okay. It's all good. I spend a lot of time with the eyes. The eyes are, to me, are the very important part of the piece. When you look at someone's face, you're always like, I look at their eyes first. So it kind of draws you in. Using some steel wool here, the coarse stuff. You can buy at any hardware store. Pretty available. In the UK, they call it wire wool. It knocks off the high points, smooths things out, generally speaking. Here I'm using a scribe and a pin vise to work around the eyes and give some slight details. it's a tedious process and methodical somewhat when you're starting a face like this. Yeah, I just switched over to a different kind of burr. It's a Dremel bit. I think it's made from Dremel, actually. It's a needle burr. It's really pointy and sharp, so you got to be careful when you're handling it. But it's pretty good for, minute details. Hey, maybe this has been thought of before, but I was thinking about instead of throwing out used burrs, to refile them down and make some new kinds of burrs out of them. That might be a neat idea. Just a thought. I thought I'd throw it out there. Yeah, this is a point where, the face is starting to come to life, more or less. The eyes are coming out, stuff like that. Just working on a mustache here. This guy's gonna definitely have a beard. Yeah, I'll finish up doing the mouth on the final part, which is going to be in the next second part video. So, but we won't get to that in this video. You're probably wondering why I'm doing this in three parts. Well, I'll explain that right now. Basically, I don't have a very dedicated internet connect, and it takes forever to upload large files. So basically, that's why I'm splitting it up. Fact is, the nearest town with a grocery store is about 80 miles away, so it's pretty remote where I'm at. Yeah, I just switched over to a diamond burr bit. It's for the smoothing purposes. It's not an aggressive bit. Yeah, I moved over back to aggressive burr, basic carbide burr. So I always switch around. You always have to do that, obviously. Well, we're coming up on the end of part one, so I hope you guys enjoyed this, and maybe you've gotten some ideas or tips, and maybe if you want to make some comments, feel free to do so. Again, thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. Stay tuned for the next part. It should be out in a few days. So, talk to you later.